I am Sachin Rathod, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are dealing with simple gear train. So the learning outcome of this session is student will able to calculate speed ratio of simple gear train. So simple gear train. Generally the gear train are used for reducing the gear ratio or the speed ratio. So in that simple gear train, if on one shaft only one gear is mounted, then we can transmit the speed or the power from one shaft to the another shaft by using the different gears mounted on the shaft. So in this case the shaft are parallel to each other, the gear having the input shaft and this one is a output shaft. So on this input shaft and output shaft, the input shaft is called as a driver and the output shaft is called as a driven or follower. So here we are giving the input speed and we are getting the output speed. So here we are occurring the speed ratio. We have to find out the speed ratio. So the speed ratio, speed ratio is nothing but the speed of driver divided by speed of driven. So in this case this is a gear number 1, gear number 2. Gear number 1 having the teeth T1, gear number 2 is having the teeth T2, gear number 1 is having the speed of N1, gear number 2 is having the speed of N2. So we can find out the speed ratio is equal to speed of driving N1 by speed of driven N2. So in this case we can easily find out the speed ratio. So suppose we have taken two gears, gear number 1 and this is a gear number 2. These are the PCD, pitch circle diameter. So from the gear number 1 to the gear number 2 we can transmit the power or the motion. Suppose the gear 1 is rotated in the clockwise direction, gear number 2 will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. So in this case this PCD, so if the two gears are meeting with each other, the module of the two gears should be the same. So the module M is given by, it is a ratio of PCD divided by the number of the teeth. So gear number 1 and gear number 2 having the same module, so we are getting D1 by T1 is equal to D2 by T2. So we are getting the relation D1 by D2 is equal to T1 by T2. So we are having the another relation, the PCD of this gear, the two gears are meeting with each other at that time, the pitch line velocity should be the same. So we are getting pi d1 n1 is equal to pi d2 n2. Therefore we are getting d1 by d2 is equal to n2 by n1. So we are getting the relation from equation number 1 and 2, we are getting n1 by n2 is equal to T2 by T1. This is the equation number 3. So we are getting the one relation between N and T, that is N1 upon N2 is equal to T2 by T1. That is the ratio of the driving gear to the driven gear is equal to the number of teeth on the driven gear to the number of teeth on the driving gear. So the speed is inversely proportional to the number of the teeth. So by using this relation we can easily find out the speed ratio. So in this first diagram A, here the driver and driven, so we can find out first one, speed ratio is equal to speed of the driving gear, that is a N1 upon N2 is equal to, now it is a inversely proportional to the number of the teeth, that is a T2 by T1. So if you observe the figure number B, speed ratio is equal to speed of the driver, this is a driven gear and this is called as an intermediate gear. Gear number 2 is called as an intermediate gear. speed ratio is speed of the driver divided by speed of the driven, n1 by n2, sorry, n1 by n3. So we have to find out the n1 by n3. So in this case, 1 is meshing with the gear number 2, that is n1 by n2 is equal to t2 by t1, and 2 gear mesh with the gear number 3, n2 by n3 is equal to t3 by t2. Therefore, multiplying equation number 1 and equation number 2, we are getting n1 by n2 into n2 by n3 is equal to t2 by t1 into t3 by t2. So here t2 will get cancelled and n2 will get cancelled. Therefore, we are getting n1 by n3 is equal to t3 by t1. Therefore, the speed ratio is equal to n1 by n3 is equal to t3 by t1. So here we are getting the speed ratio is equal to speed of the driver divided by speed of the driven is equal to number of the teeth on the driven gear divided by number of the teeth on the driving gear. So here we are not considering this number of the teeth on the intermediate gear. So similarly, for figure number C, we have to find out the speed ratio is equal to speed of the driver. Gear number 1 is a driver and gear number 4 is a driven, therefore n1 by n4. So similarly, we have to calculate the speed ratio of the n1 by n4. So for that purpose, gear number 1 is meshing with the gear number 2. So n1 by n2 is equal to t2 by t1. Another n2 gear mesh with the gear number 3, n2 by n3 is equal to t3 by t2. Another gear number 3 mesh with the gear number 4, n3 by n4 is equal to t4 by t3. So by multiplying equation number 1, 2, 3, we are getting n1, n2, n3 divide n3 and n4. So here n2 will get cancelled, n3 will cancel, is equal to t2, t3, t4 divided by t1, t2, t3. T2, T3 will get answer is equal to T4 by T3. Therefore, the speed ratio is equal to N1 by N4 is equal to T4 by T3. So here also we are getting the speed ratio is equal to the speed of the driver divided by the speed of the driven is equal to number of the teeth on the driven gear divided by number of the teeth. So here we can think about this. Why intermediate gear is used? So here we can use this intermediate gear. Here it doesn't affect on the speed ratio. So we are using the intermediate gear for if the distance between the driver gear and the driven gear is more, at that time we are connecting the driver gear and driven gear by using this intermediate gear, and for giving the direction of the motion. Means if these gears, two gears are there, if the driver gear is rotated in the clockwise, driven gear rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. So if the driver gear is rotated clockwise, yeah, and we require the driven gear rotates in the clockwise, at that time we are using this intermediate gear. So there is a two use of this intermediate gear, for changing the direction of the output gear and for increasing the distance between the two gear. So here one question is there. The gearing machines as shown in the figure, the motor shaft is connected to the gear 1 and rotates at 975 rpm. The gear wheels 1, 2, 3 and 4 are fixed to the parallel shaft rotating together. The final gear 4 is fixed on the output shaft. What is the speed of the gear 4? The number of the teeth on the gears are given below. So directly we are knowing speed ratio is equal to the speed ratio of, this is a simple gear train, because on the one shaft only one gear is mounted, that is called as a simple gear train. So speed ratio is equal to n1 by n4 is equal to, this is the speed of the driver divided by speed of the driven, is equal to the number of the teeth on the driven gear divided by number of the teeth on the driving gear. So here in this question they had given us gear number 1 means the speed of the driver, n1 is equal to 975, and they had asked n1 is equal to 975 975 divided by N4 is equal to T4 by T1. So number of the teeth on the 4 is 45 divided by number of teeth on the 40. So therefore, we are getting the N4 is equal to 975 into 40 divided by 4975. We are getting 866.666 rpm. So like this we are getting the speed of the outputs. So I have taken these two references. Thank you.